Traveling to Bangalore by train has been a long-cherished dream for every Mangalorean. Though the railway track between Mangalore and Sakleshpur is completely ready, the passenger train has still not been introduced. When asked the concerned officials, we get no reply. TV Daiji World gives an exclusive coverage for our viewers for the delay in this project. Mangalore has the maximum connectivity facilities than any other district headquarter in the state. But what it lacks is a good transportation facility with the state capital. This is the main reason why Mangalore is lagging behind in its development. The tracks between Mangalore and Bangalore were removed in the year of 1996 for the purpose of converting it into a broad gauge. There is more than one reason for this delay in the Mangalore-Bangalore rail project. So, all the aspects have to be dealt with utmost care.
I met the railway board chairman, Mr. Batra, and I explained the situation. I told that on 10th and 11th of April, the CRS inspection is over. But till today, you have not tried to have the passenger train running on the Mangalore-Bangalore. I immediately said that he called these officers, and when he inquired the matter, they said that no CRS inspection report has come before the railway board.
The main reason being the National Highway 48, which connects the Mangalore and Bangalore, is never free from terrific potholes. Secondly, the bullet tankers carrying gas and the lorries carrying timber and mines have worsened the condition of the roads. Added, these roads are proved dangerous to other vehicles which are travelling on this highway too. On the other hand, the ultimate challenge the railway department has is to get green signal from the Railway Safety Commission, which comes under the Central Aviation Ministry. Here also they are not free from the hurdles.
Certainly there is something fishy behind all these things. Otherwise, at least they ought to have sent the report to you. I don't know what is the report that is given by the CRS. Immediately he got wild and he called to the CAO, he called to the Southwestern Railway General Manager, and he directed them to give the report within 2 days. And he told me that after 2 days, I will get the report and let you know the matter in detail.
The tracks between Subramanya and Sakleshpur, specifically a place called Shiribagilu, said to be not safe for passenger trains, basically on rainy seasons.
It is learned like that. There are bus owners lobby working behind all these things. That I expressed the same thing to the chairman, and chairman told that he will inquire the matter.
Working out on the hurdles and keeping in mind the safety of the passengers, the Railway Safety Commission has at last given green signal for starting passenger trains on the route. Sources say that bus lobby is one of the major reasons for this delay. If the passenger trains start to Bangalore, the bus owners who run their buses to Bangalore would suffer a huge loss. Hence, they are forcing not to start the passenger trains early. Because of these lobbies, a common man's dream to travel in a train to Bangalore has not come true from the past 11 years. With inputs from Melka and cameraman Austin, this is Latushinoy for TV Daiji World.